Hey, what's up? This is Andy from Every Time I Die, and you're getting pumped full of Metal Injection.
I'm here with Andy from Every Time I Die. We're here at the Sounds of the Underground. Pretty hot. It's pretty hot.
It sucks out. The other day we played in Virginia and like four people like passed out.
Have you been partying hard on the road?
No, dude, I don't want to admit what I do. I don't sleep until like 6 in the morning because a certain dude that I know in the metal community, meaning the guy that did our DVD, Doug Spangenberg, who isn't metal at all, or part of the community, he found a way to like burn comics onto CD. So I was up, literally up until 6 in the morning reading comic books. Make me feel alive. This isn't metal at all.
I mean, it could be perceived as such.
We were just watching Benchwarmers, too.
Yeah. We were just citing how Benchwarmers is a epic moment in cinematic history.
Yeah. Revenge of the Nerds and then Benchwarmers really did things for, like, goobers, dorks, and nerds out there. And that is where I am, because I don't... I'm not a metal dude that fucks chicks or drinks or does drugs. I read comic books in my bunk. And watch Benchwarmers. And I get really excited when David Spade's on.
Are you a big David Spade fan?
Super. I was so bummed when they cut him off SNL. And I'm waiting for a Best of David Spade DVD to come out because I don't think they have it yet.
The Christopher Walken one is pretty gold.
Well, he's just clutch.
Yeah.
All around. There's a story, I think it was like Renee Zellweger or someone like, man, this is totally not metal. Renee Zellweger, someone was talking about how they were out, she was on the movie set and fucking Christopher Walken like was eating this apple. And just took a bite of it and then put it in his pocket. And then like 8 hours later, pulled it out and finished it.
Christopher Walken's pretty metal though.
Yeah, he's really metal. It's like Dio, Metal Injection, Christopher Walken, and then Ozzy.
Yeah, definitely. It's gotta get inside my heart. It's gotta get me all hard. You guys are putting out the Big Dirty produced in September.
Yeah.
So what's the vibe of this record?
Who knows, man? I guess it's just a little more like... just trying to entwine everything that we've done, like, in out of all four records, like, on this one. So it's like a technical, groovy thing. I don't even know how to explain it. But when you listen to it, you'll know it's us. But it's like literally doing everything that we've done. Like, every song has a bit of everything in it. It's pretty cool.
It's not like Every Time I Die's version of Saint Anger or anything, is it?
Damn it. Can't believe you got me.
Now, you guys are on Guitar Hero 2.
Yeah.
I gotta say, it's one of my favorite songs on the game. Do you guys think that it's harder to play the song actually or on Guitar Hero?
I could show you how to play that song right now on a normal guitar, and it's way easier. I can't play that shit. I suck at Guitar Hero. Fuck that game.
So, you guys have been on Ozzfest, Sounds of the Underground, Warped Tour. Been on, like, every fest known to man.
Name a summer festival we've been on.
Are you guys sick of the whole Summerfest thing? Are you guys just going to go on the...
We're going for Lollapalooza next year. We're going for Lilith Fair, dude.
Lilith Fair? You're going to bring it back. You're going to reunite.
Yeah, we're all going to get sex change and fucking play with Sarah McLachlan. we've done everything, man. We've ran the gamut, as they say. It sounds the Underground's awesome because there's the dudes that are like responsible for our band set this thing up. Like our booking agency, our management company, and our label all have shit to do with this. So, like, it's always cool, like, it's kind of like doing something for your parents, you know, that, like, I'm doing this one for my mom and dad, but it's, like, my label agency and management dudes.
Do you get special treatment since you guys are, like, in with them?
I mean, let's put it this way. I got this thing right here. This thing right here, the blue wall access, you're not supposed to be able to do, like, the cooler shit, but if you have a red one, like, you're the fucking man.
Yeah, so right here. Now I don't understand. Wouldn't that defeat the purpose of an all-access pass if you can't do all things?
Dude, okay, here's the thing. These dudes are responsible for, like, metal tours and managing bands, but they can't figure, like, normal, everyday situation shit out. Like that.
So have you guys been partying with the other bands? Like,
yeah. We rage with Darkest Hour a lot.
Cool. Any crazy things happen that you could go on the record for?
Yeah. How about the other day, we did like an off-date show on the way here with the Acacia Strain and Shadows Fall. And a KKK guy came up to me and asked me if I wanted to go downtown and beat up some black people. I'm not even kidding. And then later that night, some girl went on Shadows Falls bus, and she was a stripper at some place called Southern, well, I don't know what the fuck it was called, and she had a tampon in. She got totally naked but had a tampon in it. It was pretty funny.
Oh, boy. Yeah. That's got to be erotic.
It's I was reading a comic book the whole time. I didn't even look at it. I was thinking about cowboys.
Cool. Well, I think we're about wrapped up.
That was probably the worst interview ever, huh?
Let's get to some Every Time I Die metal injection.